In this video, a complete guide to everything you need to know to have an amazing holiday in Mallorca. Hi everyone, my name's Eve and this is what I do. I create holiday and travel guides. Also, for Mallorca, this is what I did. I traveled all over the island, visited all the different resorts on the island, holiday destinations, lots of different hotels, found out what you should do, what you shouldn't do, and a lot more. All of this compacted into one video, this video, with everything you need to know to have the perfect holiday on Mallorca. In the first part of this guide, I want to give you a quick overview of all the different holiday destinations and resorts on Mallorca, as well as my top 10 hotels selected out of the over 200 hotels I visited on Mallorca, so you can have the right place and the right hotel for your holiday. You can always find the full list of all the hotels I selected also on my website, checkedholidays.com. The first holiday destinations I want to mention are the three that are closest to the airport. These are Campastia, Playa de Palma and El Arenal. The bigger ones of these are El Arenal and Playa de Palma. Both of these kind of flow into each other and basically form one big resort. They're very much aimed at German and Dutch speaking tourists and two different groups, I would say. There's a younger generation who likes to come here, party and be noisy. These ones are more likely to stay towards El Arenal, while on the other side you have in Playa de Palma, the more family oriented scene, I would say. There's more upscale restaurants and upscale beach bars and things like this here, and also a very nice beach. So if you like to come as a family, you're more likely and better off to go to Playa de Palma. There's lots of different and unique hotels in this area. If you're coming as a family, I would definitely advise you to have a look at the Iberostar hotels. If you're coming on an adults-only holiday, then I can definitely advise you the Pure Salt Garonda. The Pure Salt Garonda is in my top 10 of hotels on Mallorca. It's a great adults-only vibe. From the hotel, you have great views over the surrounding area, and it's very close by to the beach, but as well as much of the bars, restaurants, and nightlife. So for all these reasons, definitely a hotel I would advise on Mallorca for an adults-only holiday. Campastia is very close to El Arenal and Playa de Palma, but a little bit on the outside, so you don't get disturbed too much by the nightlife and the noise this sometimes creates. So if you like to be close to all of this, but still a little bit on the outside, a little bit away from all the noise, then Campastia could be a great location for you. There's also great seafood restaurants in this area, and you're also quite close to Palma if you like to explore Palma a bit. The city of Palma might be one of the best known destinations on Mallorca, especially because so many of the excursions go here, but it's also a nice place to stay, but it's more for a cultural holiday. There are beaches here, but they're not necessarily the nicest one on the island. If you want to be a little bit in the area of Palma to explore some of the culture, but don't want to be directly into the city, then you might also want to have a look at Illetas, Calan Mayor and Portas Naus in the same area. So past these smaller resorts of Illetas, Cala Mayor and Portal Nus, you have two of the bigger resorts on the island. These are Palma Nova and Magaluf. Palma Nova is the family-friendly version of Magaluf. It has some really nice beaches, loads of restaurant shops and pubs. It's really a family-friendly destination, but there's also a little bit of nightlife spread in here as well. So all of these are much aimed at English, Irish and Scottish people, but also Swedish and Scandinavian people like to come here as well. Magaluf, on the other side, is really the clubbing and party place of the island. It's normally really well known with a lot of people for being a little bit less upscale, a little bit less classy, but Mallorca has been trying to change a lot here over the year, making it much more upscale and classy as it used to be 10 or 20 years ago. Here you will also find one of the hotels I definitely had to include in my list of the best hotels on Mallorca. This is in my top 10. It's the Sol Beach House. It's close to the nightlife, but far enough away from the nightlife not to be disturbed by it. It's right next to the beach and got great views over this beach as well. The hotel has this really fresh and unique breezy style to it, which makes it great for being located next to the beach. And it's adults only. But don't worry if you think I'm only gonna include adults only hotels in this list. This is not the case. There's coming many more family hotels, all-inclusive hotels, also luxury hotels and many more in this list of my top 10 hotels on Mallorca. Next up are Santa Ponsa and Peguera.
Santa Ponsa is very similar to Palma Nova, but a little bit more chilled and relaxed, I would say. There's less hotels here and it's also spread over a bigger area. Then Peguera is personally, I think, one of my favorites in the west of Mallorca. You will find a very big mix of nationalities here. Also many German snack places and restaurants. They really do a good job. One of the things I like this place of keeping the cars away from the tourism in this area. So it really has this relaxed holiday town vibe. So this is one of the reasons I really like Peguera on Mallorca. Also in Peguera, you will find one of my top 10 hotels on Mallorca. This is the Secret Mallorca Vilamil. There's many reasons why this is in this list of top 10 hotels. One of them being that this hotel has been here for many, many years, offering great quality hotels. It's also located in the heart of town. It's got a little bit like raised up view over the beach, so great beach views and right next to the beach. Got a nice, relaxed, luxury vibe in the hotel. And once more, this is an adults only, but I'm telling you, there's coming many, many more other type of hotels also. It's just by coincidence that the first three in this list are the adults only hotels. Just as an extra tip, if you want to be near Peguera, but in an even more relaxed setting, then I can definitely advise Cala Fornells. It's just outside of Peguera. There's a nice little small beach here and only 2, 3, maybe 4 hotels. So a nice relaxed place to be just outside of Peguera. A little bit further away, you will also find Camp de Mar. It's pretty small. There's not really many hotels. The area is mostly popular for real estate development for the rich and also the golf course here. The beach is good, but there's not really much of a nightlife if this is what you are looking for in this area. In the next town over, you will find Port Andraç. I would not really call this a beach holiday destination. There's no beach here. There's just a few nice hotels next to the sea. Because of the fishing port, there are many great restaurants here serving fresh fish and seafood. It's very popular for the people with a bigger, more upscale budget, I would say. For the next holiday destination, we have to go all the way to the other side of the island. In the west, there's only one real holiday destination here. It's the Porto Soller. It's a really nice green and lush place. This is because of the microclimate in this area. It's much more lush and green. However, in recent years, it lost a little bit of a charm here because there's so many tourists coming here on day trips. This is not much of a problem most of the time, but in high season, it can just be a little bit too much. For the next destinations, we have to go all the way to the north of the island. Here you will find Cala San Vicente and Puerto Soller. Cala San Vicente is definitely one of the smallest destinations in the north with just a few hotels. It's got a nice beach, but don't expect any clubs or real nightlife here. It's mostly residential in this area. Then next up we have Puerto Poyenza. This is one of my favorite destinations in the north. It's mostly a collection of small and boutique hotels and a harbor and town area that remains still very authentic. This is not a place to visit on a budget, but it's not really expensive here either. It's somewhere in the middle. Very popular with English people, especially in the somewhat older generation. But there's of course also coming families here. In the north of the island, you will also find Alcudia or Puerto Alcudia, as some people say, Camp Picafort and Playa de Muro. Puerto Alcudia is a typical family-friendly holiday destination with a lot of different nationalities coming here. It's big and it got a nice family-friendly beach. The area is basically two different areas rolled into one. There's the Greasy Mile, which is more the budget area. And then to the other side, you have the harbor area, which is much more for an upscale audience. The prices are also a little bit higher, but there's much more to see and do here as well. In the evening, there's a few clubs, but mostly bars and pubs that make up the nightlife in Alcudia. It's also in the port area that you will find the Zafiro Palace Alcudia, so close to the marina where you will find a lot of things to see and do in the evening. There's also many great restaurants. It's a bit more of an upscale area. It's also recently completely renovated, so very nice and new there. It's an all-inclusive hotel and definitely great for a luxury family holiday with lots of different things to do in the hotel as well, lots of different pools. So if you're looking for an all-inclusive luxury family holiday that is in a great location, then the Zafiro Palace Alcudia is definitely a great hotel for you. Then next up is Playa de Muro. Playa de Muro, I would say, is a smaller miniature size version of Alcudia. So if you like everything that Alcudia has to offer, but you want it a little bit more small and compact and more relaxed, then Playa de Muro is definitely a great location for you to go on holiday on Mallorca. It's also in the most quiet and relaxed part, right next to the Albufera Nature Reserve in Playa de Muro. You will find the Zafiro Bahia. It's a great hotel. It's right next to the beautiful beach that is in this area. It's possibly one of the best different pools you have in this hotel. So many different pools to choose from. There's adults only pools, there's kids play pools, there's pools with a view, there's swim up suite pools, there's loads of different pools here. So if you like pools close to the beach, is definitely great for you. Also, there's lots of entertainment and activities in this hotel, so all around a great family holiday hotel in Playa de Muro. Next up here in the north is Camp Picafort. It's a bit of a mix of Alcudia and Poyenza, I would say, but mostly popular with German and Dutch speaking holiday makers. It's a family holiday resort, but with mostly small kind of boutique style hotels right next to the beach and the sea. So this keeps it pretty authentic. The bigger hotels are in the back of the resort, but still within walking distance of the beach. Further to the east of Mallorca, you will find Cala Mesquita, Cala Rajada and Fonda Sacala. Cala Mesquita is a smaller place, just located a little bit outside of Cala Rajada. You can walk from here over the mountain to Cala Rajada or take a taxi or a bus there very easily. But this is a smaller place with just a few hotels, maybe three or four quite big hotels, and a very nice white sand stretched out beach. In Cala Mesquita, you will also find two of my favorite hotels in Mallorca, also included in my top 10. A lot because of the nice location, but also because of the great hotels. The first one is the Viva Cala Mesquita Resort. This is a very large hotel with lots of different things to see and do, and very much aimed at families. It's very close to this nice beach that they have here, and it's all inclusive. The next hotel is the Viva Suites and Spa. This is from the same group, so very similar in design and layout, but it's a little bit further in the back of the resort, but still quite close to the beach, but in a nice and quiet location, a little bit further back in the resort. And this hotel is aimed at adults only holidays. Cala Rajada is the bigger one of the two resorts, much bigger actually. There's many, many hotels here. It's a resort with lots of things to see and do. There's two different beaches, as well as lots of things to see and do in the evening. There's many clubs here to go clubbing. There's beer gardens all over the resort. So really active day and nightlife. You can find it all here. It's very popular with Germans, but also recently has become more popular with Italian people visiting Mallorca. Here you will also find again one of my top 10 hotels in Cala Rajada and Mallorca all over is the Lago Garden Hotel. It's very quiet and peacefully located. It's got this really unique and authentic vibe, and the main attraction here is the big spa. There's a really huge spa. If you really want to have a nice and relaxing holiday, this could be a great place for you, but you're still within easy walking distance from all of the nightlife, just far enough away not to be disturbed by it. Fonda Sacala is also located just outside of Cala Rajada. In a lot of ways, it's very similar to Cala Mesquita. There's a nice beach here and just a few hotels. Next up, you have Cala Bona, Cala Mayor and Sacoma. Cala Bona and Cala Mayor are right next to each other. Cala Mayor is the bigger one. It's very similar to the resorts I previously mentioned, like Cala Rajada and Alcudia. It's a big touristy destination with all kinds of nationalities who like to come here. There's active nightlife, loads of hotels, restaurants, bars to choose from, and a very nice wide stretch out beach. It's a bit of a busy destination, so if you don't like it too crowded, too busy, too loud, then you might as well go to Cala Bona. It's just next door and you can easily walk to Cala Mayor. A little bit further down, but still within walking distance from Cala Mayor, you have Sacoma, and it's quite similar to Cala Bona. It's also a very nice touristy destination. It feels a little bit more Spanish. It's a little bit more laid back and relaxed. It don't feel so crowded. So also, if you like this, a very good destination for you. Then also here you will find two of my favorite hotels. One is the Pro Tour Biomar Gran Hotel. This is a luxury holiday destination, especially great for families with kids. If you like to go on a luxury holiday with your children, this might be a great place for them. And it's a really peaceful and relaxed location right next to Dunes area. The next hotel is also a Pro Tour, it's the Pro Tour Safari. This is the one that's a bit more budget friendly, but also still a great family friendly hotel. If you like to go on holiday with the kids, then this is a great hotel, especially because it's also close to a zoo and a water park. So it gives you a lot of things to do, but the hotel itself also is great. It's also a short walk away from Cala Mayor if you do want to visit on some nights or some days, a little bit more busy, active resort with a lot of restaurants, then it's also great for this. From Sacoma to Calador, you will also find many more smaller beaches with just a few hotels next to them. So if you really like to get away from it all, get away from the mass tourism, really escape on Mallorca, then this is a great destination for you. You can find all these smaller destinations easily on Google Maps. I cannot cover them all here, but they're all great. Calador itself, also definitely a place I can advise for anyone.
In the next part, I want to focus a bit more on things to do while you're on Mallorca. There's loads of shows, excursions, day trips you can do. Also some really nice beaches you can visit. This I want to focus on in the next part of this video.
The city of Palma is one of the most visited places on the island. While a lot of people like to come here for shopping, there's also the other side, the more cultural side, and one of the most visited attractions here is the Palma Cathedral. If you do want to experience some of the history and culture of Palma, this is definitely a great place to start. However, there are also many other things to see and do around Palma. If I can give you one advice, it would be, however, if you have the possibility to visit after 6 o'clock in the evening, especially in June and July and August, because Palma can get pretty busy. If you come in the evening, it feels more authentic and less touristy. There's great restaurants, great outside terraces, and great bars you can enjoy. So definitely my advice would be, if you're coming in the high season months, to go in the evening to visit the city of Palma. If you don't have much time on the island, one of the things I can definitely advise is the Kathmandu Park for a lot of variety family fun. They have a lot of different things here. There's 4D cinema, there's mini golf, laser games, and much more. This is also set in a very unique setting. So no matter if you're visiting on a sunny day or a rainy day, there's in and outside activities here. It's great for a family variety day out. There are also a lot of great shows that you can go and see on Mallorca during your holiday. The first one I want to discuss is the Pirate Show. Offers two great editions. One is for the entire family and one is a more 18 plus show. The Pirate Show has been on Mallorca for many years and is still one of the most visited shows on the island. This one is located in the Magaluf-Palma Nova area of Mallorca. The other show I would like to mention is the Son Amar show. It's the other great show on Mallorca that offers a lot of variety. There's singers, dancers, magic, acrobats, and much, much more. It also changes pretty much every year. They add in new things and they take out the things they didn't like so much. So it's always, even if you've been there before, it might still be worth a visit. You can also enjoy great dining here as well. There are a lot of great water parks on Mallorca. My only advice would be, if you're traveling in high season, so July and August, do pay a little bit attention because it can get very busy in these places. And I may or may not advise you to go, depending a little bit if you take a VIP pass or express line or something. If you're just gonna go on the standard ticket, it might not really be worth it. So be aware of this. In July and August, the water parks get really busy. One of the things I would highly recommend doing if you're traveling to Mallorca, especially if you're staying in the north area, because then you're a bit closer by, is to take a visit to the Rancho Grande. This is one of the best places on Mallorca to go horse riding, but they also offer much more as well. A petting zoo, sangria wagon, there's barbecue, there's line dancing, shows, and much more. All in all, a great day out for the entire family. Another thing I definitely want to advise you is, whenever possible, to go on excursions on Saturday, because this is when most of the people on the island arrive or leave. So this means that those are the days that they are not going on excursions, meaning that many of the excursions on the island are a lot less busy. Therefore, this is one of the best times to visit such places like the Western Water Park, Kathmandu, and other of the main popular tourist attractions. However, you will have to get there yourself in most cases, as often organized excursions don't visit these parks on Saturdays because many buses are occupied with going to and from the airport. The Palma Aquarium is one of the newer attractions on Mallorca and great for all ages. There's much more to do than just watch fish in aquariums, including lots of things to do outside as well. This is great fun any day, but especially on a rainy day, I would definitely advise taking a look here.
Mallorca has a lot of beaches and sometimes it can be quite hard to choose which one is the right one for you. Here are my top 5 beaches you should visit while on holiday in Mallorca.
On number 5, near Magaluf, you have Portalsfels. This is a great beach, quite nearby to Magaluf. You can easily drive here, but it's tucked away far enough so not too many people know about it. Nice shallow waters, not too much waves, and nice little beaches spread all throughout here. There's actually 2 or 3 different little beaches depending on how you look at it. Great place to go to the beach. Just outside of Santa Ponsa, you have the Cala Blanca beach. It's tucked away, so not too many people know about it. There's a nice little beach bar there. It's great for snorkeling. There's not too many waves, and it's also a diving board in the water. So if you'd like to dive and jump a little bit into the water, you can do it from here. There's also these tiny little beach balconies, I would call them, if you like to relax right next to the water. All the way off the beaten track near Soller and Daia, you will find the Cala de Sa Costa Brava. This is really tucked away. There's not really anything here. It's totally away from the mass tourism. It's a great little place to go and swim. I wouldn't say there's really a beach here, but there's a great restaurant here. So a really unique place to go and have a swim on Mallorca. Near Alcudia, you will also find Sillot. It's a pebble stone beach, so there's just rocks here. There's not really any sand here, but it's definitely one of the best places on the island if you like to go snorkel, because the water is just super clear here, because there's no sand in the water. There's also a little island you can go and dive off and explore, so definitely a unique place on Mallorca to go snorkel or go to the beach. A great beach for pretty much everyone would have to be the Playa Romántica. It's great also for families because there's all the facilities you would like nearby, but it's still not a big beach. It's still quite untouched and quite authentic. There's also the Coco Beach Bar here that do some really good cocktails. They also do like evenings where there's live music and barbecues. So definitely check that out as well.
So I talked a little bit about what to see and do while you are in Mallorca. In this next part, I want to also focus on what to avoid and what not to do, as I think it's quite important to talk about as well.
The first thing I would advise you to do is to stay away from flyers you find on the street. Most of the time they offer some kind of cheap excursion, but there's always some kind of sales presentation or a heavy sell included as well. So I would definitely advise you to stay away from these kind of things. They sound like a good deal, they sound very cheap, but there's always a catch. So always book your excursions either through your rep or through the reception or through a sales office that is in the street that you find and that you find good reviews on. The next thing is with regards to the illegal sales that are happening on the beaches of Mallorca, but this can also be in the streets. If anyone sells you something without a license, he himself can be fined, but also you now can be fined for buying from this person anywhere from 100 to 750 euros. This can be for a lot of different things, but most of the time these are being sunglasses that are being sold, but it can also be for fruit that you buy on the beach from people that don't have a license, or any kind of drinks, or if you partake in any kind of illegal activities, like for people that don't have a license, if they offer hair braiding or something on the street, this falls under the same law. If they do hair braiding in a restaurant or in a shop or in a hotel, then it's all fine. Then most likely they have a license to be there and it's correct. But just on the streets and on the beaches, watch out buying anything from anyone, because if they don't have a license, you yourself are liable as well. If you are renting a car in Mallorca, then pay very good attention. It's not only a Mallorca problem, but all the destinations I travel to, I see this more and more people getting ripped off when renting a car, because they search online for a cheap deal, and this most likely is with a car rental company that doesn't have the best reputation. They always will try to upsell you things, sell you things that you don't need, add extras on your bill, claim that you've damaged the car even though you didn't. For all of these things, I've noticed this everywhere. Be very good paying attention to these kind of things. It's even become such a big problem, I dedicated a special page on my website to this. It's checkholidays.com/cars, where you can find all my advice for renting a car the correct way without being ripped off.
Each year I get a lot of different comments on my videos saying from people that they're gonna visit Mallorca soon, but that they're gonna visit in February or March or something like this. This for most people ain't the right time to go. So in this next part, I quickly wanna set straight when is the right time to go, when is the wrong time to go, and when is the ideal time for you to go to Mallorca.
January, February, March, November and December are normally not really the months that most people come to Mallorca. It's not really beach weather, so definitely not for most people, but it is good for those who like to come here to train, either to do swimming or to do some other kind of sports like cycling or running. It's very popular with cycling teams from all over Europe who come here to do their winter training. So if you like to do sport, it's a good time. If you like to go to the beach, then it's not for you. It could also be a great time to come on a bit more cultural holiday. In that case, possibly rent a car or at least be in the general vicinity of Palma so you can get around a little bit. There is still things to do in Mallorca around this time. It's also quite popular with elderly people, older people who like to come here to sit out the winter if it gets too cold in their country, like many of the Scandinavian countries. April is a little bit of a difficult month. If you're coming near the end of April, you might be taking a little bit of a risk, but it could pay off as well. You can get really cheap deals. Not many hotels will be open, not many of the attractions will be open, and not many restaurants will be open, depending a little bit on where you go on the island. If you go to some of the bigger places like Alcudia or Playa de Palma, there will be a lot more open around that time. Palma Nova the same as well. So if you need to go on holiday April and you have a lower budget, could be a great deal for you, but try to aim for the later months. But hot weather is not a guarantee, but it could be. May and October are the first and the last month of what I would call the good weather on Mallorca, the right time to go for a beach holiday. If you're going in May, aim towards the later weeks to make sure that everything is open by that time and also the weather is the best. If you go in October, then aim for the first weeks in that month to make sure everything is still open and that you also have the best chance of having good weather in Mallorca. The hottest and best weather you will find in Mallorca in June, July, August and September. These are definitely the best months if you like to go on a beach holiday. Do know that July and August are normally the hottest, but they're also the most expensive. So if you're not traveling with children or not have a reason to go in July and August, go in June and September because it will be less expensive and also it will be less people on the island, so you have a more relaxed vibe overall.
In this next part, a quick guide of how to get from the Mallorca airport to your hotel, cheap, fast and easy.
First way to get from Mallorca airport to your holiday destination is to take the public bus or the public transportation. Public transportation is actually in Mallorca is quite good, but do know it can get a little bit overwhelmed in July and August, the high season months. The good thing is you can just hop on at the bus at the airport. There's no reservation needed. There are direct buses, but they don't go all the time. Normally they're 1 or 2 hours in between, so it might be that for some destinations you have to transfer the bus in Palma, which I would definitely not advise if you have a lot of luggage or a lot of kids with you. Also not for late arrivals, because the buses, they don't run till late in the evening, or if your plane is delayed, this is definitely not the best way for you to get from Mallorca airport to your holiday destination. If you're going to a beach destination in one of the bigger resorts, then also an option for you could be to take a shuttle bus. It might actually be your best option, because normally the prices are the same or cheaper than taking the public transportation. It's also direct. This is to say there might be some stops along the way, but you don't have to transfer anywhere onto another bus. But do know that you have to book these ones before online. You cannot get on at the airport. You have to book them before online. There's many different companies offering these kinds of services. The services I like to use, you can also find on my website, as well as all the companies I like to use when traveling on my website at checkedholidays.com/links. Definitely the fastest and most direct way is to take a taxi. This one will get you there very fast, but it's also a little bit more on the pricey side. Normally it only becomes financially interesting if you're traveling with 3 or 4 people. So do keep this in mind, because prices aren't cheap and they get a bit more expensive even in the evening or in the nighttime or in the weekend. Do know that the taxis you get at the airport take maximum 4 people. If you're traveling 5, then you will have to take 2 taxis. Also the taxis at the airport, the prices are not set. So if there's a traffic jam or the taxi driver can't find his way, they can go up. And also normally at the taxi stations, they don't have any car seats. So also do keep this in mind, car seats for small children. If you want to have a taxi for more than four people, if you do want to have car seats, and if you do want the price to be the lowest and to be set so it don't go up, then do know that you can also find the links to the companies I would advise on my website, checkedholidays.com/links, where you can find the links to the taxi companies I would advise you to book with on Mallorca to have the best and smoothest experience.
If you're not 100% sure if this is the right holiday destination for you, feel free to have a look at any of these other videos. I have 250 more guides here on YouTube at the moment. And of course, you can also find many more on my website at checkedholidays.com.